don't have enough time, but let's start. Remember this? Anybody remember this? This is a Mueller report. Remember all this? Hundreds of subpoenas, hundreds of witnesses, millions of pages of documents, nothing. They still have nothing. I want to tell you how concerned the Democrats are about foreign interference in our elections. First of all, Obama did nothing to stop the Russians from interfering in the 2016 election. In fact, his administration spied on this president of the United States when he was a candidate. It was Hillary Clinton who colluded with the Russians and the DNC. They paid for that dossier. You know all this. Well, let's talk about the Democrats and how serious they are about foreign interference in our elections. I'll go to my book briefly, if I may. Back in the 1990s, we had a president by the name of Bill Clinton. He was impeached, but he wasn't impeached for what I'm about to talk about. He was running for re-election. The media really didn't care much about this scandal that broke. The LA Times and a few others did. And here's what they wrote. The chief of China's military intelligence secretly directed funds from Beijing to help re-elect President Clinton in 1996. Former Democratic fundraiser Johnny Chung told federal investigators. Chung say he met three times with intelligence officials who ordered $300,000 deposited into the Torrance businessman's bank account to subsidize campaign donations intended for Clinton, according to sources. Chung spread around a great deal of foreign money on Democratic candidates and organizations and bought himself repeated access to the White House. He, quote, contributed more than $400,000 to various Democratic campaigns. This is Chinese military money. Visited the White House no fewer than 50 times and brought numerous Chinese associates to events with the President and First Lady Hillary Rodham Clinton. That would have been Trump's opponent, you might remember, in 2016. Charlie Tree, a longtime friend of President Clinton, raised $1.2 million in foreign dollars for the Clinton Legal Defense Fund and the DNC. And in March 1996, Tree dropped off a donation of $460,000 at the Washington offices of the Clinton Defense Fund, with some of the money and sequentially numbered money orders made out in the same handwriting. He visited the White House 22 times. Los Angeles Times, James Riotti, another longtime friend of President Clinton, who heads the worldwide Lippo Banking Group, pleaded guilty. He was involved. The Times also noted that former Democratic fundraiser John Wong, a one-time official at Lippo, pleaded guilty in the scandal 2 years ago. What did he do? Wong raised more than $1.5 million from illegal foreign sources, visited the White House 78 damn times. There's your Democrat Party. Now, what did Nancy Pelosi say when the red Chinese military was spreading millions of dollars around to the Clinton campaign, to the DNC, and all the rest? She didn't say a damn thing. Where was the independent counsel investigation? There was no independent counsel investigation. Where was most of the media? They were nowhere. Here's another one for you Democrats out there. In the 1980s, we had a president called Ronald Reagan. He was phenomenally popular, but Ted Kennedy wanted to stop his re-election. What did he do? Information in the files, been reported by the London Times, been reported by Professor Kengor, in the files of the KGB, through back channels, the lion of the Senate, who many on the left wanted to be president of the United States, tried to collaborate with the KGB to defeat Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan, his second term. There's your damn Democrat Party. What else? Oh, the GAO comes up. Perfectly timed. Gives a damn, another bureaucracy. Donald Trump broke the law. It's not what it says. Donald Trump broke the law, they say. Well, if Donald Trump broke the law, as they point out in PJ Media today, well, then so did Joe Biden. Remember that $1 billion that Joe Biden said, hey, look, Ukraine, you're not getting that $1 billion unless you fire that prosecutor? Well, that $1 billion was appropriated by Congress in March of 2014 by a vote of 399-19 in the House, 98-2 in the Senate. And he tried to blackmail the Ukrainians, and he tried to threaten withholding of funds. Well, where is the line that Joe Biden broke the law? Now, we have this guy, Lev Parnas. Told you, don't have a lot of time, but I'm moving. Who's Lev Parnas? Well, he's the latest guy that the Democrats are gonna grab. He has been indicted on multiple felony counts. He is a foreigner who used foreign money and tried to put it in our campaign. Now the Democrats want to hear from him, and the media call it Evidence. Evidence? Now, the media took us here before with Michael Avenatti. Where is he today? His ass is in jail. Remember the porno star, Stormy Daniels? Where's she? No idea. Michael Cohen, remember him? He was going to bring down Trump on campaign charges. Where is he? He's in federal prison. Now, something funny about these two articles of convention of impeachment. There's no constitutional violation. There's no statutory violation. There's no violation of a federal court order. This is why they keep throwing up smoke. And I want to tell these five Republicans in the Senate, the weak links in the chain, Romney, Collins, Murkowski, Gardner, and the other one skips my mind, luckily. Alexander, let me tell you something. You have a duty to uphold the Constitution. What the House of Representatives has done here is destroyed the Constitution. It's your job to fix it. It's your job to stop them, not aid and abet, by calling witnesses that the Democrats want. No, no witnesses, no witnesses. This should be dismissed. This is a disgrace. That's it.